My name is Brent Huffman. I'm a documentary filmmaker. I've been making a documentary since 2011 about the ancient Buddhist city at Mes Aynak and the sort of incredible people trying to save it.
I was thinking I was going to capture on film this Buddhist city before it would be destroyed, so at least there would be a visual record that it existed at all. Everything that I've heard from the archaeologists says that certainly by the end of December, archaeologists will be forced off of the Mes Aynak site. Once you get to the Mes Aynak location, the actual archaeology site is absolutely incredible. It's an awe-inspiring site to see. It really reminds me of a site like Machu Picchu in Peru in terms of massive structures. It's just an enormous site. It's actually a city that's about 400,000 square meters in size, so it actually encompasses several mountain ranges in the different parts of the city. There's a monastery complex. There's dozens of temple structures. There's 400 life-size or bigger Buddha statues. A lot of these structures you can actually go inside, you know, and see different levels of sort of like residential ancient Buddhist homes. A lot of these homes have stupas inside them, so little temples where Buddhists would worship inside, and a lot of these stupas are incredibly intricate. There's decoration all over them. The same thing with the Buddhist statues. A lot of them still have the gold paint on the surface. This 2,600-year-old Buddhist city was a major hub on the Silk Road. So you saw trade all throughout Asia and the Middle East, Buddhist monks making pilgrimages from different people traveling to the site. So all these different cultures, all these different people sort of meeting in Mes Aynak for trade, for worship. So then you sort of saw all these different cultures influencing each other. And some of the finds in Mes Aynak sort of show that. There's statues and artifacts found made from material, you know, that comes from Pakistan or that comes from Iraq or China or India. Afghans will be losing a huge part of how important their own history is and how influential Afghanistan was to the rest of the world. Buddhists could come visit this important site. Tourists could come learn about the cultural significance of Afghanistan. The film is probably about 60 to 70% complete. I'm returning to the site in December. I'm seeing the last days. I'm sort of bearing witness to the end of this archaeology site.